Welcome to Astro Talks with Los Angeles-based professional astrologer Astro Chris, your source for weekly astrology, spiritual talk, and moon magic. Your energetic support is much appreciated, and I thank you for your 5-star rating. You are a star. Gracias. Now, this week's astrology, the hot topic is Mars. Mars is going to be ingressing the sign of Aries. That will be on May the 24th at 4:21 p.m. PST. So that would be 7:21 p.m. EST. Now, this is a big deal as Mars is the natural ruler of Aries. And the other reason this transit is very significant and important is because Mars is a personal planet. And as a personal planet, he rules a lot of intimate things that we experience much more stronger than the social planets. Mars rules our action. Mars rules how we take this action, how we stand in the energy of I in relationships. And the drive that we have, how is it that we tackle things in our life? How much energy and vitality do we have? What is our strategy? It also rules the person in a relationship as an individual and how they are representing themselves within that relationship. He also rules the season of starting anew. A very healthy and strong Mars in our chart will have us starting projects with zeal, with enthusiasm, and lots of energy to conquer the impossible. So Mars is a big deal. This ingression is a big deal. Additionally, Mars takes about 2 years to travel through the entire zodiac belt. Thus, we don't get a new cycle of Mars yearly. And Mars is in very good dignity in the sign that he's ruling. He's also going to make some very powerful conjunctions and aspects in general to the rest of the other planets while he is transiting the sign of Aries. It's also very important to note that this time is very significant because after this Mars transit, we have some tough Mars work to do. Mars will be transiting Taurus, then transiting Gemini, and then going into a retrograde period for the remainder of the year until it goes into Cancer, which is not a favorable sign for Mars. So we do need to be very mindful on the actions that we take. Now, mind you, with Mars in Aries, we are going to be more energized and willing to take these risks. But I do want to warn you that this is not really that time to take those very daring risks as Mercury is still in retrograde. So retrograde is still in full effect. And Mercury is also making a very powerful trine to Pluto. This is a secondary trine. He's going to trine Pluto one more time when he goes direct. But when Mars ingresses to the sign of Aries, Mercury is at 28 degrees, forming this trine with Pluto. Now, Pluto is similar counterpart to Mars, as they're the co-rulers of the energy of Scorpio. So Mercury is still having that agenda of Mars, a strategy as it's communicating to the other ruler of Scorpio. Now, Pluto is in Capricorn, so it also flavors a very concreting of ideals and actions and things that you plan to take into execution and work on very diligently for a very long time, because that is the energy of Capricorn. It likes to set plans in motion and strategically take steps to achieve the highest tops of whatever it is it's set to achieve. But it does it very strategically, step by step, planning and executing as it reaches the top. That just highlights the thought process that we should have. And we have to kind of tailor these impulses to take actions without thinking. Because Mars is ready to tackle the world. He loves a challenge. The Aries archetype is one of the signs that likes to have or be in competition. So sometimes it creates scenarios around itself to be in a competitive environment and show off its skills. Now, when it comes to losing, that's a whole other story, but they'll still keep going and they'll rematch you over and over and over, even without thinking that, hey, the first couple of times I lost, so there's a possibility I'll keep on losing. And the impulsive Mars energy doesn't necessarily always think very thoroughly in strategy. And actually, this is a gift, as there's some people that strategize too much. They stay in the dream mode and never take action. Now, Mars needs to tailor down and strategize a little, think a little, but then strike with force, with vitality, with direction. And the combination of Mercury being in retro, trining Pluto, is slowing down the energy of Mars so we can do exactly that. Versus when Mars is full on impulsive, taking action, like I mentioned, is great, but sometimes taking action may also not allow us to take the more optimal option or the correct option, which can cause errors and redo. Thus, to avoid this, we do need to pause a little to really take that action. Again, it's going to be a hard time because Mars, in its true essence, on a world point, he's ready to conquer the world. And he's also the last of the personal planets to be reborn, to have a new cycle. As Venus already went through that, and we have already had Mercury go through that. We already had the Sun go through the new cycle. So Mars is the last one of the personal planets to really flag in, hey, I'm starting a new cycle. Immediately when Mars goes into the sign of Aries, it also is accompanied by a moon in Aries. So this is also going to be felt very embodied within us, because the moon is our body. It's the fluids within our body. Now, in the energy of Aries, it's going to be much more fired up and playful. So this is a great day to just go out there and have a lot of movement incorporated throughout your day. This could be running errands, because the moon likes to do a lot of things, right? And Mars is very active. So it could be running errands, or it could be going to the gym, or maybe depending on your placement of this Aries house and how it aspects your chart, it's also a very ideal time to set in that workout routine, or maybe improve it. So incorporating something of renewing and refreshing routine, especially anything related to Mars. The moon also rules the mother archetype in our chart. So we're going to see more advocacy around issues regarding the mother. I am going to be making a video on Ceres and how Ceres is showing up currently in the formula shortage. But you're going to see some developments with this Mars ingression agitating the moon a little, meaning the mother archetype is going to start speaking up and advocating. And we also have Venus forming a sextile to Saturn, Venus representing the women archetype in the sign of Aries, being influenced by Mars, which speaks about how the government, Saturn, will have to set regulations around topics of women and home and children, because Mercury is retrograde. So this is a continuance of a conversation, something that has came about. And it actually came about during the pandemic, in which that was the last time Mars has formed a new cycle in the sign of Aries. Now, this is also impacting men, young men, and even adolescents are included in the archetype of Mars. So this ingression to the sign of Aries is showing how the energy of males, male energy, and all of us have them. This is not about gender. It's more about the positive expression, if we want to use positive and negative, if we want to use yin and yang. So it's more of that expression being highlighted within all of us, and it really impacts the positive or yang or male masculine energy. So this chart is going to be speaking about how this gets expressed within the transit. Mars also joins Venus momentarily in Aries, and this is significant because it's part of their cycle. Remember, they created a new cycle this year at 0 degrees in Aquarius. So when Mars hit that 0 degree in Aries, it's actually sending a sextile to the union that they've created, and Venus still being there. So Mars is like trailing behind Venus, bringing up themes of relationship. Venus is going to form a square to Pluto. So although Pluto is communicating friendly with Mercury, things that are connected to more intimate relationships are going to surface up, and Mars will help Venus express itself, as Venus does not do as well in the sign of Aries, but the ruler of Aries being there is going to help Venus kind of stand in her truth and really express the individual needs and wants that she wants within these relationships. But Pluto pushes these things to come out. Maybe these are things or topics that you really did not want to discuss because they're quite hurtful or very deep down inside that you don't want to revisit. Mars is going to assist in cutting them out, facing them, and moving past it. This week is a big week for the fire signs and the air signs, the water and earth signs not feeling this energy as much. But we are closing out that watery Pisces cycle as Mars leaves the energy of Pisces and leaves Neptune there. No longer are we experiencing the overflow of Piscean energy as all the planets have formed a new cycle and we're moving forward. So this is a week of new beginnings. I thank you for your time. Thank you for being here. Your support is much appreciated. Thank you for that 5-star ranking. Thank you for subscribing, hitting that notification bell, and following me. And don't forget to catch me live on IG. I go live every Thursday where you can ask the astrologer a question. Have a great one. Love and light.